Assalamu alaikum, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to an episode of Community Debate, Washington, D.C. I'm Sana Ali.
And I'm Talha Siddiqui. Nazreen, pichle program mein bhi humne nayi nasal ke numaindon se guftugu ki thi. Is program ke andar bhi humne nayi nasal ko hi daawat di hai. Aur aapne New York ka program dekha hoga, usme ek bahut hi ahem baat jo discuss hui, wo tha phenomena of ABCD, American Born Confused Desi. Ye jo phenomena hai, ye maine bhi jab main yahan aaya तो महसूस किया और ये अब तक चला जा रहा है हमें ये देखना है कि जो बच्चे यहीं पैदा हुए हैं और यहीं पर वो स्कूल जा रहे हैं कॉलेज गए हैं उसके बाद अब ये इसी माशरे का एक हिस्सा बनेंगे उनकी क्या सोच है कि अभी तक वो एबीसीडी हैं या उस फिनोमेना से बाहर आ चुके हैं
There's no doubt that there is some tension, Dr. Saab, you would agree, for the younger generation reconciling jo hamare desi values hain with the Western ideas. Yahan pe individual agency ki bahut zyada ahem role hota hai. Aur hamare jo panelists hain, they're a very dynamic group of people and we're going to hear their insights today.
Aaj hamare saath maujood hain Seher Sohail, graduate of Marymount University, aspiring doctor. She began the popular account called Pakistani Martha Stewart that deals with social issues, particularly for the Desi woman.
Our second guest is Muhammad Muaz. Yakeenan aap unse mil chuke honge. He is the creator of the very popular viral account Desi Bombshell. He has worked in Pakistan on issues of gender equality and counter-extremism issues. And he is currently a graduate student at George Washington University in Washington, D.C.
Our third guest is Shamsi Khan. She's a pre-med student at the Columbia University with a major in political science.
And lastly, we have Mohammed Sufian Qasim. He is a senior tech consultant with the U.S. Department of Veteran Affairs. He's also an aspiring entrepreneur. Isse ilawa bhi, he's a prolific writer. He's written on many of the hot-button issues today and also spends a lot of his free time in several volunteer organizations in the Washington, D.C. area. So our first question, we're going to just delve right into it. Ek bahut popular theory hai of the clash of civilizations. इस पर किताबें भी लिखी हैं इस पर बहुत सारे डिस्कशंस भी होती हैं और इसका बेसिकली इसका जेनेसिस ये है कि इन द मॉडर्न वर्ल्ड द बिगेस्ट सोर्सेज ऑफ कॉन्फ्लिक्ट्स आर गोइंग टू बी पीपल्स रिलीजियस एंड पॉलिटिकल आइडेंटिटीज सो आई वुड लाइक योर ओपिनियन सहर आई स्टार्ट विद यू आपको लगता है कि वाकई ये क्लैश ऑफ सिविलाइजेशंस हो रही है और इज इट अ क्रेडिबल थियोरी डू यू थिंक
डेफिनेटली टॉकिंग अबाउट पाकिस्तानी अमेरिकन्स लिविंग इन द यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स I feel like we do have a clash. There is a clash of cultural identities. Mm-hmm. Whether you're born and raised in the United States, whether you were born in Pakistan and moved here and you're living here, there is definitely that sense of a clash of cultural. When you grow up in the United States, you have a certain way, you have a certain lifestyle. You know, for example, me living here, sometimes when somebody comes up to you, they ask you, so where are you from? You'll say, I'll think about it. I'll say, do I want to say, am I from the United States of America first? Do I say I'm from Virginia? Do I say I'm from Pakistan? You wonder if I say, if I'm from the United States, am I denouncing my Pakistani heritage? Mm-hmm. If I say I'm Pakistani first, am I denouncing the fact that I was born in the United States? So I feel like there is this clash where you feel you're a foreigner in each country, where in the United States are, am I really Pakistani? Or, you know, in Pakistan, do you really feel, am I American?
Moise, I'll ask you. Clash of civilization. Samuel P. Huntington, you know the theory. Bernard Lewis, Fukuyama, all that. Do you think it is actually going towards that? Or do you think people have worked in the opposite direction of assimilation?
I don't think it has headed there. I think we are already there. The process has already begun. And it also takes this unique tangent of itself, because identities within themselves is a very American concept. It's something that ever since I've been here, I've noticed that people tend to identify a certain way and assert their identities in a certain manner. And that thing is definitely taking place on a global political scale now, particularly with the fact how Muslim or Islam has become less of a faith and more of an identity over here in the US. So people who are Muslims, you know, would identify as Muslims. आप जो हिजाबिफिकेशन को लेके आप पूरे का पूरा इशू देखें या वी द पीपल के अंदर जो अमेरिकन फ्लैग को एज ए हिजाब यूज किया गया था So a lot of beliefs of faith systems have become less of beliefs and less of faith systems and they have become more about identities. So identities ki over assertion itni zyada hui hai ke a clash was it had to happen eventually. So I would take it that way.
Shanze, what would you say? Do you agree with Maz that we are already in the era of clashing of civilizations?
Absolutely not. I would say sabse pehle baat ye hai that to be American is not antithetical to being a Muslim. When Ben Carson said that I don't think a Muslim should be president because he's not in line with our constitutional values, there was an uproar about it. And that's because we all acknowledge that to be tolerant, to be law-abiding, to live in a pluralistic society is in no way contrary to being a Muslim. So I think that there are tensions, but to label it a clash of societies is actually to reinforce certain ideas and stigmas and will contribute to it.
Mm-hmm. And I want to add to that, that when Samuel Hamilton wrote that, that was 15, 20 years ago, you know.
1992.
So more than even that. Okay. Since then, the world is becoming smaller and smaller. Pakistan is known as a global village, or, you know, but it's becoming smaller. And there's a concept of new, like, international identity, you know. If you, you know, you could look at millennials' profile, and they don't call themselves American, they don't call themselves Virginian, you know, they call themselves international traveler, you know, or international resident, Earth resident. So I feel like, you know, the world, right now, you know, we're in the middle of identifying that self. Like, I feel like we're going through the revolution, going through the process. We are becoming, we're moving toward realizing that everybody is one, you know. These artificial boundaries don't define us, you know.
Do you really think hum is direction mein ja rahe hain jahan puri duniya mein ye attitude hai ki we are one? Mujhe to lag raha hai ki western world mein borders or identities bahut zyada aham role le rahe hain. So now you are American, and what is American? Aap sun sakte hain news pe ki bahut sara racism hai.
It's a reaction. Like, whenever there's a revolution, there is or there's a new process, there's nothing something new being invented, there's always an extreme reaction to that. So, you know, but obviously, you know, as the technology is progressing more, we are definitely moving toward that. You cannot stop it. You will have extreme reaction to that, you know. But at least, like,
you think it's a temporary reaction, which has
it might, yeah, the way I see it, temporary reaction and extreme reaction to extreme new change. You know?
So, sir, aap se puchunga, you born here, brought about here, Pakistani parents, and then there is a culture outside,
yes,
at home and outside.
Yes.
Do you think you were able to assimilate both? Do you think you were able to take both of them together?
I think it was a struggle. I think it's a struggle for any young adult growing up in the United States with kind of like a, I want to say, dual nationality, where they feel that, you know, what do I need to represent more? When I'm at home, I grew up in a very traditional Punjabi family. I have certain lifestyle at home which doesn't abide. It was a struggle in the beginning years of my college life where I was trying to assimilate both. But, you know, when you think about it, America in itself is, we try to say that we need to assimilate, we need to continue. Mm-hmm. There is an American culture. But you need to think about it. What is American culture in a sense? Mm-hmm. There are just so many nationalities, so many religions, so many languages, you know. I feel in itself, America is
Very diverse
in itself. Do we feel that we need to choose? Do I need to be American?
Was there any conflict or any difference within the household between the outside culture and the culture within the home?
I feel the conflict is more individual, where I feel, you know, sometimes should I be doing this thing a certain way? Mm-hmm. When I go to college, do I represent myself in a certain way? Mm-hmm. It was definitely a struggle when I was working outside of home, you know, in the medical field, you know, when you know, in culture, we're like, you know, just it's a strict environment,
right,
and such.
Right.
But you know, you just eventually you will find a sort of equilibrium. Individually, I think you will get there. It's just all interception. You just have to look in.
Basically, aap is struggle mein akeli nahi hai.
Yes. Hamari
general community inhi issues se grapple karti rehti hai, especially first generation and second generation as well. Hamare jo producer hai Yusuf Chaudhary, unhone community se baat ki thi isi mauzu pe, aur ab hum unki raaye sunte hain.
Jis tarah yahan par hum log rehte hain, bacche ya grown up hote hain, to agar hum unko batayenge to zarur wo unko malum hoga culture kya hai. Even in Pakistan mein rehte hue bachchon ko pata nahi hota culture ke bare mein, kyunki wahan par bhi log nahi bata rahe hote aur na itna culture follow kar rahe the khud parents. ظاہر ہے بچے بھی فالو نہیں کرتے لیکن یہاں پر ذرا مشکل ہوتا ہے اس لیے کہ باہر کا ماحول ٹوٹلی ڈفرینٹ ہوتا ہے بچوں کے لیے
میں نے بہت بڑا ڈفرینس دیکھا ہے کلچر کے اندر پاکستانی بچوں کے اندر اور امریکن بچوں کے اندر امریکن پاکستانی بچوں کے اندر respect ka factor jo Pakistani culture ke andar izzat log baro ki religion ki jabo ki aur sab ki jo izzat dikhai jati hai wo in bachcho ke paas nahi hai wo struggle wo hustle wo izzat hai nahi and that's the biggest difference culture ke andar Pakistani aur American bachcho ke andar
Maybe a clash and there may be a lot of differences, but at the end of the day, even if we're raised abroad, we're always going to be Pakistani and follow the culture of our parents that want us to follow and falling from our roots.
They are all like IT people. Hum log hamare zamane mein IT ka itna rawaj nahi tha, to isliye there is a lot of difference in their thinking and our thinking. We are early risers, they are late risers, and all these things, you know, they do count. So there is a clash, I would say, a little bit of that. But we are adapting that or we are getting closer. Apne aap ko thoda sa change karna padta hai. Young generations ko bhi aur apna older generation ko bhi try to cope up with that.
Nazreen, aapne humari community ke views sune. Dobara main isi guftugu pe aunga. I'll ask you, ke, within your home and outside, how are you able to reconcile between the two cultures?
I would say that I fall more on the Americanized, you know, end of the spectrum. But I would call it a spectrum because to call it a binary, that you are Pakistani or you are American, that is a misnomer. Mm-hmm. So...
And continuing that, right? So, just like you go to work, so, you know, you are Mr. Kasim, how are you doing? Professionalism, se, bilkul English, mein, bilkul tarike se sab baat karte hain, theek hai? Aur ghar pe aate to ammi bolti hai, beta pudina mangaya tha, tu karela lekar aayi hai, you know, pudina dhaniya lekar aayi hai. So, like, jab ghar mein aate to bilkul ghar ki identity hum log adopt karte hain, theek hai? Ghar pe aake bilkul, you know, environment, wahan par jo bade kahenge, wo kahenge. Aur kaam pe jab jaate hain, to, you know, ek senior, jaise ke, senior, elderly, Gora, jo bhi hoga, aapka senior, or you know, if you don't like their opinion, agar aapko nahi pasand wo kya keh raha hai, aap disagree karte ho, you're like, sorry sir, I disagree with you, aur aap bologe, theek hai. Whereas ghar mein aate to, ammi jo bolegi, ya abbu jo bolenge, ya agar aap kisi rishtedar ke yahan par ho, wo jo bolenge, bilkul wahi sahi baat hai, theek hai. Aap bilkul sahi keh rahe ho. And you go with that. As whereas at work, you know, or you and you're in school, you can you know completely be yourself. So it's very different environment. But we know as soon as I step in the house. You know, I'm a Pakistani, you know, a Maiman Pakistani.
So, your identity boy, you know. Change ho jati
right,
hai.
Exactly.
So, Sufyan, jitna aap is topic ko feel kar rahe hai, this specific issue, jo hamari cultural role hai for women, women feel it even more. Ke aapko ek ek kamre mein, ek ek environment mein, aapne apni personality ko usi situation ke liye kaise tailor karni hai. So, actually, I will ask the creator of Shamaila Bhatti, ke aap zara mujhe ye bataye, what is the role of women in our culture coming from back home? And what is how does it have friction with the role of women that maybe our women see or experience when they live in the US? Because in Pakistan, mein bahut different role hai, desi culture mein bahut different role hai. Yahan pe bhi challenges hai for women. So how do you reconcile that, Maz?
That's a very loaded question.
Of course it is. It's a great question.
Yeah, and it's a great question as well. And I think I would like to start off with a softer, more diplomatic answer, and then we would get after the more controversial bit about it. So one essential sociological difference between the two cultures is that the American culture is more individualistic in Rand Valley philosophy. Pakistani culture is very social. It's very collectivistic, as we know. Wahan pe jo role of jo idea of womanhood hai, jo idea of femininity hai, it is very socially ingrained. A woman, while playing her role as a woman, does not think about herself or her individual self as much as she has to take into account her role as a sister, mother, you know, all of that bit. वो जो हम लोगों ने किया हुआ यहाँ पे आके वो बात ज़रा सी डिफरेंट हो जाती है दोनों कल्चर्स के अंदर फॉर साउथ एशियंस लिविंग इन पाकिस्तान और लिविंग इन द यूएस हमारा जो आइडिया ऑफ मॉरल प्रोप्राइटी है या जो मोरालिटी का जो हमारा कॉन्सेप्ट है दैट इज़ ऑलवेज लिंक टू अ वुमन्स बॉडी एंड हर एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ हर सेल्फ एंड हर पर्सनैलिटी तो पुलिसिंग तो वुमेन की मौजूद है पाकिस्तान के अंदर वो पुलिसिंग बहुत जस्टिफाइड है और वैलिडेटेड है इन आर कल्चर नॉट इन आई एम नॉट सेइंग दैट इट्स वैलिडेटेड दैट वे आई एम सेइंग वो वैलिडेट कर दी जाती है बिकॉज सारा माशरा ही ऐसा होता है सो यू कैन नॉट रियली प्रोटेस्ट इट Over here, I think it becomes more of a conflict because you growing up as an American woman would feel that, you know what, I have certain agency and control over myself, which I can't really exercise because I'm being told to behave in a certain manner. And that's, I think, what you were talking about. So the conflict, the contestation, we get to see here because it's the opposition. Hai. You can voice that opposition when you cannot do that in Pakistan.
Have you been to Pakistan?
Yes.
So, पाकिस्तान में जो रोल है ऑफ वुमन और यहाँ पे जो है आपको क्या फ़र्क लगता है व्हाट डू यू थिंक इज़ द डिफरेंस
फ़र्क इसमें है कि
you know, in Pakistan, we have our homemakers. We have a couple women that are, you know, in professional fields. I think it's definitely growing a lot more than it has in the last 10, 15 years. We've come a long far. There are still some difficulties that we deal with. But, you know, in America, I feel as a woman in itself, you already face many difficulties that Pakistani women back home also face. So it's not to say just because you're in America, you're not going to face problems. You're not going yes, definitely. Like in the workplace, the pay difference. Sometimes, you know, there are many issues that we could delve into. It could be a whole discussion on its own.
Women are fighting for equality.
Yeah,
all over the place.
It's not just Pakistani women.
This is one of the most engaging issues, especially when it comes to the cultural clash, is specifically about women. So, abhi hum is conversation ko continue karte hain. We're going to take a short break. But first, I'd like to thank two of our sponsors. Hamare pehle sponsor hain New York Medical Career Training Center. They're a top-notch medical licensing center in New York City. Unki do locations hain, one in Flushing, Queens, and the other one in Manhattan. Hamare second sponsor hai Abid Tax Company. As you know, tax season aa raha hai, so if you don't want the stress of doing your taxes, please get in touch with Abid Tax Company. We'll be right back.
Welcome back from the break. Shanze, I'll ask you, usually we see that in this culture, basically the children, they meet their parents once or twice a year when they're in professional life.
Thanksgiving.
Okay, Thanksgiving, Christmas. Now, what our system basically is more of a family-oriented system, right? And here it's more individual. And, you know, so, do you think our next generation, your generation, is changing and adapting the same values of, you know, like individuality?
Nay. I mean, I would come home once a month to see my parents. If I had the choice, I would come home every weekend, but I don't have that option. It's a little bit, I think, incorrect to say that the society would only come back once or twice. But if you are raised in a certain household that's loving, then it's really up to the individual. I know Desi children who will only see their parents like twice a year, and then I know white kids who will also come home at every opportunity. So I don't think we're changing so much in that regard.
So do you think it's not an issue?
I don't think that's an issue.
What do you think?
Personally, since I come from a traditional household, even going for college after high school, my parents, they wanted me to stay near home, so I went to Marymount University, and it was only 15 miles away. I would drive back and forth to school. At some point, I did feel, you know, maybe if they allowed me to go to some other college, you know, a couple states away, you know, would things have been different? But I'm actually happy where I am, where, you know, there are some advantages to living at home, you know. Sometimes Americans will ask you, you know, where do you live? You know, I say I still live with my parents, and I don't see it as something, you know, demeaning, or, you know, if I'm held back behind because I'm still living with my parents. I like to have that traditional core in the household. I love staying with my parents. I feel I can give back to them as well. I know many kids don't, and I'm not speaking for everybody, but for me personally, I like the traditional way of, you know, living with my parents.
Sufyan, you have to add something?
Yeah, I wanted to add something on that, right? So I, when I was going to college, maybe up to parents, my parents are, they have physical issues, so they need somebody to take care of them, at least be around with them, you know. Lekin in retrospective, it's helped me, right? So when I come home, I have emotional support, right? I know there's somebody, you know, if I need to, something needs to be done at home, I know there's somebody to come home, you know. Mere paas financial pressure nahi tha. Mujhe itni zyada loan lene ki zarurat nahi padi, theek hai? So after, when I graduated, for my first job, you know, I moved to California, you know. Mere paas student debt nahi thi. I got a job that I wanted to do, and I went out to California, and I lived there for a year, you know. And I did what I wanted to do, and then, you know, then there was a need again, I came back home. But for a year, you know, I didn't have to worry about money, I didn't have to worry about anything, you know. And as I was in college, the more support was always there. People get homesick. Jo college jaate hain, unki grades bhi low jaate hain. Pros and cons hai, theek hai, like, college jaane ke bhi on living on your own, you know, and also there's pros and cons of, you know, living at home too.
That's right. Agar aapke paas ek bahut supportive relationship hai with your parents, so the college years when so much is happening, it's nice to have that base. I also stayed at home with my parents during undergrad, and I think it was 100% the right call. Now we're just going to switch gears. Ek dusra zara topic hai. I think Moiz, you touched on it a little bit when you were saying ke Islam is less of a faith as much as it has become an identity that people wear wrapped around themselves. Pakistan and many cultures around the world have the identity of the person tied with religion. Lekin America mein kam az kam foundationally ek bahut clear separation hai between church and state. Isliye I think individual ko bhi zyada agency milti hai, because there is this marked history of the separation. So do you think ki ye jo do cultures se jab hame inka samna karna padta hai, do you think this causes an issue when you no longer have to have a religion that's such a part of your identity in a culture?
I think depend karta hai ki aap uski jo aapki wo jo religious identity hai uski enactment kahan pe hogi aur kis tarike se hogi. So for instance, if you are in Pakistan, and in Pakistan to being Muslim is not really a big thing because you're part of the majority and it's a semi theocracy anyways, right? So aapki jo political
semi theocracy kahan se hogi Pakistan?
Islam is the state religion.
Yeah, but it's democracy, right?
Yeah, but it's still a
semi-theocracy. It's an Islamic Republic of Pakistan. Let's
exactly
not forget.
I would still call it, yeah, I would still call it a semi-theocracy. Religious persecution, hamare paas, it's state-sponsored. Hamari constitution ke andar maujood hai. So that would, I would call it a semi-theocracy for that. Hum log religious, hum log qualifiers, hum log ne lagaye hain for certain positions within our government.
But if we step away from political, agar aap sirf culturally pe agar aap focus kare, so it is encouraged that you be a good practicing observant Muslim. That's a big part of your culture.
Yeah, exactly. And I think that also comes back to, at the end of the day, if you are Pakistani immigrants in the US, where are you coming from within Pakistan? And what were your ideals of being a good Muslim from back home, jinko families of course permeate karengi into their own kids and etc. wo wali baat aapki zara si aage chalegi, lekin I think where it becomes slightly wo jo clash ki jo hamare paas thodi si baat ho rahi hai when it comes to with the individual freedom and when it comes to liberal politics for that matter, wahan pe aake zara si mujhe personally wali baat feel hoti hai ki zara si contestation hai. I might be wrong, lekin I personally think that the South Asian diaspora in the United States is slightly homophobic when it comes to it. And there are some issues within our community jinko yahan pe address nahi kiya gaya. Hum logon ne misogyny and sexism within the South Asian community ko address nahi kiya. Hum logon ne racism and homophobia within the South Asian community ko address nahi kiya. We are talking about anti-Muslim bigotry. We are talking about Islamophobia, and there's a very valid issues. But we also need to talk about these problems that are present within our community. And I think that the young generation is doing something about it.
I'd like to ask a follow-up, Seher, if I can ask you. Aap jo apne images mein depict karti hain, especially jaise Moiz is saying, the misogyny that is unfortunately a reality of the Desi culture, ye hum kaise phir reconcile kar sakte hain? Kyunki bahut sare Pakistani immigrant families hai yahan pe jo apni betiyon ko wo agency nahi dete because of a lot of their preconceived beliefs. So that is very frustrating for women now, don't you think?
It is most definitely. It's frustrating in the sense that you would think that once our parents have come to the United States, that why do we come to the United States? We come for hope. We come for a different way of life. We come to bring our children and have them be raised in a certain way where they can adapt an American lifestyle. They can garner more success. I feel that parents.
Do you think that's why people come? Because my understanding is that a lot of people come to America for a stable financial life.
For stable financial
not
life.
Not necessarily for the individual freedoms.
Right.
But after that,
yeah,
face karna
they come them. Originally, I think our parents came here for success. And you know what? They've come and they've done it. They've given us a platform for which we can stand on and, you know, shoot for more success. But I would want to talk to those parents where they are holding either their daughters or even sons back from pursuing different careers, you know. I feel like certain parents think that success comes in only a certain amount of packages, where if you go to medical school, that's the only way you will be financially stable. This is the only way that you will be finding success in the country. I think that we need to talk to them, start at the individual level, talk to your parents at home, have them feel that yes, I can get success. Thank you for what you have done for me, for, you know, going through so much struggles. I mean, coming to a different country, you know, leaving your home country behind, it's a hard, it's very hard. So I'm definitely going to be always thankful to my parents. I'm glad that they gave me the, you know, opportunity to express myself. When I made the Pakistani Martha Stewart, they didn't have any problems. They let me, they were actually proud, and I was surprised. I thought they would have been.
इसी टॉपिक पे हमारे प्रोड्यूसर यूसुफ चौधरी ने जनरल कम्युनिटी से डिस्कशन किया तो आए उनकी राय देखते हैं.
Since I was raised in America, my parents in Pakistan, there was a huge difference between the way we think and do things. A lot of times they don't understand a lot of stuff we go through mentally and emotionally, but point is we're trying to teach them a lot of things that we go through here as teenagers. While they try to teach us Pakistani culture, which I think clashes, American culture with Pakistani culture, the bottom line is we're trying to teach them and they're trying to teach us, which itself can be a very hard situation.
Sometimes hamare bachon mein hamare culture ka jo hum culture back home se leke aaye hain Pakistan se ya different islami mumalik se leke aaye hain to kuch time pe hamara wo different aa jata hai, difference aa jata hai apne bachon ke sath culture wise. हम उनको कोशिश करते हैं कि अपने जो पिछला कल्चर है हमारा उसको अडॉप्ट रखें और ताकि नया कल्चर जो जो बच्चे इधर पैदा हुए हैं वो इस कल्चर को अडॉप्ट करते हैं और मिक्सअप हो जाता है कल्चर तो बहुत कल्चर वो अपने कल्चर के मिक्सअप कल्चर के साथ जाना चाहते हैं हम उनको अपने कल्चर के साथ लाना चाहते हैं तो समटाइम ये प्रॉब्लम होती है लेकिन माशाल्लाह हमारे बच्चे मोस्टली बच्चे जो है वो अपना दोनों कल्चर को फॉलो करते हैं.
यहाँ पे एजुकेशन को एजुकेशन है तो उन्हें लड़कियों में या लड़कों का लड़कियों के साथ मिक्सअप होना उन्हें बुरा नहीं लगता और रिजल्ट्स उसके वही होते हैं जो हमारे माशरे में होते हैं. किसी मखलूक इदारे में जब उनको आज़ादी दी जाती है लेकिन यहाँ पर वो आज़ादी बुरा नहीं माना जाता. हमारे यहाँ वो आज़ादी पर पाबंदी है. सो बच्चे इस बात को बिल्कुल भी नहीं मानते और उनको इस बात के लिए कन्विंस करना बहुत मुश्किल काम है.
हमारे में उनमें बहुत सारा बिग डिफरेंट है और हमने उस डिफरेंट को कवर करने के लिए हमने और बच्चों ने और हमारी कम्युनिटी ने मिल के काम करना है ताकि फ्यूचर में बच्चे और हम इकट्ठे थोड़ा ईजी रह सकें.
वेलकम बैक. आपने हमारी कम्युनिटी की आरा सुनी. अब मैं ये सवाल करूँगा आप सबसे कि आपको ये लगता है कि जो पाकिस्तानी बेसिकली जो यहाँ पे नई नस्ल हमारी अब है और जो दूसरी अकवाम है जो साउथ एशिया में ये इंडियन हैं कोरियंस हैं चाइनीज हम में और उनमें असिमिलेशन में कोई फ़र्क है इस कल्चर में किसी भी लिहाज से दे बेसिकली फील more basically okay with the culture and in assimilation jabki hamare yahan jo hai wo bahut rukawatein hain.
Ha, I would say so kyunki hum is mulk mein rehte hain kaam karte hain padhai karte hain phir bhi hum sab desi parties jaate hain aur you know sab khawateen ek corner mein
desi parties mein aap log sab jaate honge right. Do you think any of you that there is a clear distinction between how a boy and a girl is treated in a Muslim home or a Pakistani home even today in the United States?
Most definitely, and I think it starts back at home. I can think back to my brother. I have two younger brothers and you know the way they are treated, they have different expectations from the way I have different expectations. The way I go about in a society, whether I'm at a party, whether I'm at school, women are generally expected to behave a certain way, to always respect in my drawings I have that we're kind of a badge of honor in a way. You know, we're always used to represent, you know, ghar ki izzat, you know, to that betiyon ko aise karna chahiye, betiyon ko aise baat nahi karni chahiye, ye karna chahiye, wo karna chahiye. So there's definitely a huge distinction. Men sometimes tend to get away with things where young women, if they do the same thing, they are kind of crucified, I want to say, at the point like
is it changing?
I would say that we have adopted a certain brand of feminism. The feminism which we have adopted is that, wait, TK, then she's going to study, doctor ban sakti, but phir bhi ghar aake chai banani hai, you know, still has to have certain etiquettes. We have not adopted a feminism, which is like a freedom of action, a freedom of what you might want to wear, how you might interpret your faith. You know, you have to have, I guess, the worst.
But that's that more pressure on you guys.
Yes, it's most. It's like a double bind, not only.
And I don't know, as a man, I don't know if I should speak on this. Like, in just like a. It's like it is expected from the woman that they have to be perfect at the work and they have to be perfect at the home, mm-hmm. you know. And how are they expected to do both when guys can't do it? You know, if the men are superior, they can't do it both. Then why are the women expected to do it both ways? Yeah.
And actually,
if the perception is that women are superior, men are superior. Then even if they can't do it both, then why are you expecting women to do it
actually,
both?
Actually, yeah. ये जो सुफियान जो इतने advocate इस वक्त बने हैं, ये बहुत ज़रूरी चीज़ है कि जो younger generation में both men and women, boys and girls should see कि ये ज़रा gender disparity है, और हमने यहाँ पे tolerate नहीं करनी. We've done shows in the past where we've talked about जब आप मस्जिद जाते हैं, the back entrance that goes down to the cold basement for some women. Is something that younger generation notices or wo is cheez ko kabhi pasand nahi karenge or kabhi accept nahi karenge, so they will push to make it more equal.
Right, exactly. Or just like the community I grew up in, Fredericksburg, it was a very suburban town, right? So we had Muslims from a different part of the world, or just like just generation to grow up with authority na, so we all had the same identity in a way that we were all first generation Americans, right, growing up in the same environment. And we were all facing the same struggles at home, you know. And so when onto the point when the girls would come to the masjid, right, they would bring it up. You know, when we had classes, when we had community youth gatherings, you know, they would bring it up. Why are we only getting quarter of the size when actually more women are coming to the masjid? You know, initially it used to be less, but now there are more women. We need equal amount of size. You know, so I feel like the first generation are bringing up these issues.
ये चीज़ जो है gradually take up करनी पड़ेगी मसाजिद को about you know. And female, for instance, female entrance hui, yeah, unke issues hui, unpe. Aapke khayal mein masjid isme role play kar rahi hai apna?
Masjid is very being, at least the ones I've seen are being very proactive in these things. You know, they are having like special sessions with women. Women actually taking in charge. It's not the masjid that's being proactive. Women themselves are taking the lead in these cases. You know, they're bringing, you know, we need this. They're bringing up their needs. They're raising their voices. And we are seeing, at least I've been seeing more and more of this. And you know, I've been seeing a lot of changes lately.
हम अभी इस टॉपिक को दोबारा कंटिन्यू करते हैं, बट फर्स्ट वी हैव टू टेक अ शॉर्ट ब्रेक. आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक आवर टू स्पॉन्सर्स. हमारे पहले स्पॉन्सर हैं न्यूयॉर्क मेडिकल करियर ट्रेनिंग सेंटर, अ वेरी वेल नोन वेल रिगार्डेड मेडिकल लाइसेंसिंग सेंटर. उनके दो लोकेशंस हैं, एक है इन क्वींस और दूसरा है इन मैनहट्टन न्यूयॉर्क. And our second sponsor is Abbott Tax Company. As you know, it is tax season, so if you don't want to deal with all the stress, and if you're filing a corporate tax return or starting a new business, or for general accounting needs, please contact Abbott Tax Company. We'll be right back.
Welcome back from the break. आप क्या कह रहे थे मोहिश?
So what I was talking about was कि हम लोग अपनी religious values को लेके बहुत rigid हो जाते हैं, और हम लोग कभी इस वाली बात को understand करने की कोशिश नहीं करती हमारी community के religious values के अंदर भी flexibility मौजूद है, उनके अंदर भी diversity of opinion और diversity of thought मौजूद है. We just assume that what we believe to be sinful or what we believe to be wrong is the default. And there is no going away from it. And I think that is what limits you, that is what hinders you, that is what hinders assimilation when you talk about it. Because whenever you look at any culture, culture kis cheez se define hota hai? You have leisure, how are you enjoying in that culture? What is the food in that culture? Mm-hmm. What are the topics that you talk about? You know, whom do you hang out with? Aapke wo ethos kya honge sare ke sare? और इतनी एक रिजिडिटी के साथ वो हमारे ऊपर वो मज़हबी वैल्यूज़ थपेड़ दी गई भी होती हैं ऑन साउथ एशियन किड्स के वो कर नहीं पाते.
एक सवाल करूँगा जो मेरे जहन में आया है अभी, वो ये कि जो यहाँ पे जूज़ हैं, राइट, बहुत से उनमें रिजिड हैं. आई मीन अभी भी वो कोशर पे डिपेंड करते हैं, अपने रिलीजियस वैल्यू. वो तो अच्छी तरह असिमिलेट कर जाते हैं. मुसलमानों का क्या वो है मसला?
That's different, I would say, a little bit, because being Jewish is also an ethnic identity. You are Jewish because your grandparents were Jewish and because you had a bat mitzvah, not because you go to the synagogue every day and you pray. Being Muslim, at least, is a much more involved kind of faith in general, unless you are very Orthodox Jewish. The majority of the Jews who I have met, and I went to a school which is about 30% Jewish,
they're reform Jews, right? So they have adopted new practices. Mm-hmm. And this goes back to Islam being rigid. I mean, you look at the golden age of Islam, is up until the 14th century. Mm-hmm. What stops at the end of the 14th century? The practice of ijtihad. Once that stops.
There's no reformation, right?
Right, yeah. There's no reformation. You're not evolving. So you are applying a religion which was given over 1,000 years ago into a society which right. has completely changed.
Has changed. Actually, that's an excellent point that Shans has just raised. اجتہاد کے دروازے جب بہت زور سے بند کیے گئے اور آپ نے کرٹیکل تھنکنگ ہی ختم کر دی تو اب یہ جو نئے جنریشن پاکستانی امریکن چلڈرن وہ جب یہاں آ رہے ہیں دے آر کرٹیکلی لکنگ ایٹ تھنگس اینڈ دے وانٹ ٹو سی سم ریفارم سو آئی تھنک دیٹس این ایشو ٹو ٹاک اباؤٹ
ہے لیکن ایک اور چیز کو دیکھیں ٹرکی فار انسٹنس ٹرکی نے اتاترک کے بعد ٹوٹل ریفارم کیا اپنے آپ کو اور وہ اس سیکولرزم کا آئی مین تیو دے But what happened after 2000, again, mm-hmm. the religious parties mm-hmm. came back. تو مجھے یہ سمجھ میں نہیں آ رہا انہوں نے ریفارمس بھی کیے انہوں نے اپنا جو بالکل ٹوٹلی چینج بھی کیا ریلیجن کو ان مینی اسپیکٹس بٹ اٹ کیم بیک سو تو اس کو آپ کیسے روکیں گے
لیکن ڈاکٹر صاحب شاید وی آر ویری انٹالرنٹ سو I don't know if the ijtihad, like if we really stop the critical thinking there, but it's the matter that like main aata hu sochta hu ki this is what I believe in, this is what my parents taught me, and this is the right way. If I'm not, so it's not a matter of that the Islam religion in itself is not allowing you to do different way. There's so many schools of thought, you know. There are so many scholars here, you know, who are not bringing new ideas, but telling you, hey, this is what it says, you know, like Noman Ali Khan and different whoever you follow, you know. So there are ways to look at things different way, you know, when you live here. There are scholars here specifically telling you if you live here, if you deal with people, you know, this is how you deal with things. So it's not the matter of maybe, you know, at least in my view, that religion not being flexible enough. It's a matter of you personally, yourself being flexible.
Yeah. So I'll be talking about that. Yeah. And the other big thing is to know that Turkey does not exist in a vacuum. It is just as influenced by the rest of the Middle East. Mm-hmm. So Islam is not the end here. It's not a teleological end. It is a means to an end. Mm-hmm. You have a wave of anti-colonialist sentiment, of anti-imperialist, anti-Western sentiment. Mm-hmm. So if you have disillusioned people, you have people who have been slighted, who are economically marginalized, mm-hmm. then they are going to adopt Islam as this new mantle, mm-hmm. and they are going to radicalize it. So this resurgence is not about secular reform not working, it's about the fact that secular reform rejected entire sects of society.
But do you think it's because of economic problems also?
I think that's a fair question because we saw the Arab Spring happened almost entirely because of economic issues. اور اس پہ ہم یہ بھی دیکھ رہے ہیں کہ آپ کو یاد ہوگا جب ایجپٹ میں اتنا بڑا پروٹیسٹ نکلا تھا اگینسٹ دین پریزیڈنٹ حسنی مبارک لوگ نعرے کیا لگا رہے تھے از وی وانٹ بریڈ سو اف یو آر ہنگری اینڈ سم ونز پالیسیز ہیو فیلڈ یو اگر وہ لبرل ہیں یا کنزرویٹو ہیں آپ ان کے خلاف
لیکن کمنگ بیک ان دی سبجیکٹ آف ٹرکی آئی تھنک دیئر از ون ویری امپورٹنٹ پوائنٹ دیٹ وی آر مسنگ از دیٹ دیٹ سیکولرزم واز اے ٹاپ ڈاؤن ایفرٹ It was not a bottoms-up effort. Mm-hmm. You can't just expect states to come in and enforce mm-hmm. A certain way of thinking or a certain way of functioning and expect your audience to follow suit as well, you know. Mm-hmm. You can't just do that. And that's exactly what happened in Turkey by banning head covering or, you know, by banning all of that stuff. So when we are talking about reform within Islam, we are not just talking about it in the American context. We are also talking about it in the global context. And this needs to happen from within.
Sufyan. What is an American-born confused Desi? What is an ABCD? Kya cheez hai?
We get to see a lot of them, first of all, today. We don't know what we are, you know. We go home, we are Pakistani, you know. We are Punjabi, we are Pathan, we are Baloch, you know. As we go home, you know, we hang out with our friends, you know. If we hang out with our friends, with American friends, we are Sef, you know. I hang out with my Pakistani friends, I'm Sufyan, you know. When I go to my work in professional environment, I'm Muhammad Qasim, you know. So that's what ABCD is.
Aapke naam hi farak hote hain. That's true.
No, but is it still a confused thought?
Yeah. It is a confused thought.
Sean, say what do you think?
You're confused because, you know, agar main thodi si critical ho about Pakistani culture, does that mean that I have rejected Pakistani culture? You know, but I don't think so, because if I criticize America, it just means that I love my country and I'm engaging in a democratic process, you know, to try mm-hmm. to reform it. So the confusion is does my culture accept me, I think, sometimes, more so than do I accept my culture? Because I can love to be Pakistani, but I cannot say 100% that all the Pakistanis I know would accept me.
Mm.
So the confusion is, do I belong? And it's not out of our intent. Instead, it's predicated on the opinions of others.
Do you feel any sense of belonging to Pakistan?
Yes.
You do?
Yes.
You think, I'm the first generation, right? You're the first generation. I'm the immigrant. I have a sense of belonging to Pakistan. I go there. I still consider it part of me. But aap logon ka kya hai? How much depth
is Pakistani culture is divorced from like Pakistan, the land, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I feel like to be Pakistani, it can be an ideology, it can be a value system.
Arranged marriage. And basically, you know, choosing your own partner. Kitni changes aayi hain parents mein is waqt ke wo isko ke wo aap logon ko aapki choice aur pe pura depend kare, kahein ki aap aapko jo karna hai aap khud choose kare, ya abhi bhi arranged marriage ka concept hai hamare culture mein?
I think definitely ha. I mean, in my family there is arranged marriage. People will ask me sometimes, you know, going to college or school, do you have a problem with that? Are you forced into it? I don't think I'm forced into it. I will say, you know, my parents and I have a definite understanding where, you know, I would like to, at the end of the day, to choose my own life partner. I do want you to have a role in that decision-making process, because who most do you care about? Who are the people that have raised you, know you, care for you, want you to be able to have a successful marriage after it? Who more than your parents? So I definitely want them to be in that role-making process. Some people don't want to go about that, and that's totally fine. There's no definite answer, ke arranged marriage hi theek hai, ke love marriage hi theek hai, you know? I think it varies from family to family. In my family, it's more the traditional sense, ke we will go around, look for a spouse. If you like him, you can talk. Do you like each other? No? Okay, moving on next.
Yeah.
So it varies from family to family.
Sufyan, what do you think? Do you think there's more flexibility?
So what she's saying is that like it's kind of still arranged marriage, but like it's like a middle of the path, right? The flexibility, but I guess traditionally, just like my mom was telling me, कि जैसे कि जब मेरी बात पक्की हुई थी, जब मैंने तुम्हारे अब्बू को मैंने देखा भी नहीं था, ठीक है, मंगनी होने के बहुत टाइम के बाद मैंने कोई इवेंट्स वगैरह पे देखा था, ठीक है. सो नाउ इट्स कम्प्लीटली डिफरेंट, राइट? नाउ लाइक इफ़ यू नो समबडी, यू नो, और योर पेरेंट्स हैव समबडी, लाइक यू गो एज अ टीम, बोथ एज अ टीम, यू नो, सिट डाउन, यू एंड योर पेरेंट्स, होपफुली, राइट? यू एंड योर पेरेंट्स बोथ सिट डाउन एज अ टीम, यू नो, ट्राई टू फिगर इट आउट. ऑब्वियसली जैसे कि मेरे कुछ दोस्त हैं, दे हैड अ फाइट विद देयर पेरेंट्स, और उन्होंने, यू नो, दे मेड देयर विश टू बी मेड. Or my kuch dost hain, they just accepted what their parents said, and then I have a group that work as, you know, they work together and they just sit down and they try to work it out. Jo partner hota hai, jo potential candidate hota hai, they work as a team to figure it out.
So Mois, Pakistan mein aajkal kya hai? Aap to kya halat chal rahe
hain? Mois is the resident Pakistani expert on this panel. Pakistan, it's pretty much still arranged marriages. Pakistan mein to marriage is, that's another very beautiful difference.
Is it changing in the urban population?
Yeah, it's changing in the urban population. Like in Pakistan, marriage was never a romantic decision. Marriage was always a social decision. Marriage is a tool. Marriage is an institution.
Like in feudal society, what are you talking about?
Yeah, in the entire Pakistani society. Jab ke US ke andar, of course, it's a concept, I'm getting married, it means I love the other person, you know. So I think this is also a bone of contention between Pakistani Americans and how they perceive marriage. And mere khayal se this question should have gone on further. It shouldn't have just been about arranged and love marriages. Yahan pe to interfaith or interracial marriages ki bhi baat honi chahiye thi. When it comes to the Pakistani society. Oh, that's amazing. Let's go there.
Arranged marriages are not an Islamic institution, but they're born out of Islamic parameters. If you are told that it is haram to do X, Y, and Z, that, you know, to date is unfavorable, then the only way you can really find someone to be with is if you go through an arranged marriage. Because if you are going and you're dating on your own, then your family may say that's not okay.
Well, Shantay, don't you think it's very hypocritical of the Pakistani American culture, jahan ke jab tak aap 21 years old ki hoti hain, aapko khabardar agar koi ladke ke saath baat ki, but then as soon as you're 22,
shaadi
ladki ne college kar liya, shaadi nahi hui, kya ho gaya? Like aapko pata bhi nahi hota ki kis din mujhe ek dam ijazat mil gayi thi ki main ladkon ke saath baat karu, aur upar se ek husband.
I think it's funny that no one here is, we're all acting like no Pakistanis date in America. I mean, some of us might not, but we are lying if we say we don't know Pakistanis our age who go on dates. That is a thing.
And
there
are date outside of the desi.
Of course, there are people who are choosing to pursue their own romantic interests in whatever way they want to. You know, there's like different approaches to it. But this is another bone of contention, I guess, that people don't talk to their parents about this because if you have a point blank, you cannot date, then, you know, that limits options.
No, magar, once you go to the, once you all go to the college and the university, right? Usi se sawal dusra jo niklega wo yehi hai, ke, you know, interreligious marriages, right? Between different faith. Wo kahan tak acceptance aayi hai Pakistani community mein? Mere khas se to mujhe jo laga hai ke bilkul bhi nahi hai.
Bilkul nahi hai. Definitely, Naya. I mean, if you talk about just marrying outside of your race or outside of your religion, let's come back to just Pakistani marriages. You know, some families have not accepted, you know, marrying outside your caste even.
Yes.
Or marrying outside, you know.
Yeah,
if I'm
Sunni,
I think it's, you know, it depends on family. I'm never going to say something and say it's a blanket for all Pakistani Muslims. But for example, if I'm from a Sunni family and if I marry into a Shia family, you know, that's
a
huge clash, you know. That, you know, Sunni and Shia castes, you know, some, I have many friends that aren't allowed to marry outside their caste. So that in itself is a problem in itself before we even go on to, you know, different race or different religion. Yeah.
Baatein to bahut si hain, lekin hamare program ka waqt ab khatam hua chahta hai. Nazreen, aapne dekha ke humne naujawan nasal se sawalat kiye. American born confused desi, ABCD ka jo concept hai, जो यहाँ पे कई साल से है, हमने ये देखा कि वो आप चश्मा कर सकते हैं नई नस्ल पे या नहीं. वो खुद ये समझते हैं कि उनको ये समझा जाता है, लेकिन उनमें से बास का ये भी ख्याल है कि वो तो इस माशरे में असिमिलेट और घुल मिल गए हैं, लेकिन जो उनसे पहले की नस्ल है, क्या वो ए बी सी डी तो नहीं है? ये एक सवाल है जिस पर हम मज़ीद प्रोग्रामों में भी गुफ्तगू करेंगे.
और ये मैं ये ज़रूर कहना चाहूँगी कि जो यंगर जनरेशन है, दे डू रिकग्नाइज दैट देर आर सम देसी वैल्यूज़ दैट आर अमेजिंग, रिस्पेक्ट ऑफ योर फैमिली, हॉस्पिटैलिटी, आवर कल्चर, ये चीज़ें तो कहीं नहीं जाने वाली. लेकिन जो वेस्टर्न कल्चर में भी जो बेनिफिट्स हैं वो भी उनको भी हासिल करना चाहेंगे. थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर ट्यूनिंग इन. अगर आपको हमारा प्रोग्राम पसंद आया और इफ़ यू हैव एनी कंस्ट्रक्टिव कॉमेंट्स, यू कैन सेंड अस एन ईमेल एट communitydebate.go@gmail.com या आप हमें व्हाट्सएप मैसेज भी कर सकते हैं एट 917-833-5201. Lastly, I must thank our sponsors again. Our first sponsor is New York Medical Career Training Center, a very well-respected, top-notch medical licensing center in Queens and in Manhattan, and of course, Abe Tax Company. So if you're filing a new tax return or if you are starting a new company, please get in touch with Abe Tax Company. From Community Debate, Washington, D.C., I'm Sana Ali.
And I'm Talha Siddiqui.
Khuda hafiz.
Agle hafte aapse phir mulaqat hogi. Khuda hafiz.